Well, Women's Equality Day is coming up next week, a time to consider how far our society has come since women achieved the right to vote 96 years ago. The Navy supports equal pay for equal work, as nearly every single job in the Navy is now open to women. Here to share more about equality for women in uniform is Commander Hillary Darby. Welcome, Commander.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on the show today.
Sure. Thanks for being here. Talk about some of the positions you've held in the Navy.
Well, I enlisted in the Navy in 1986, got selected for the Naval Academy, was part of the 11th graduating class of women, had a great fortune to select for Naval Aviation, and that's when the world really opened up combat helicopters, combat aircraft to women, so I selected the Seahawk, and since then it's been an amazing ride. Been an officer in charge of a detachment at sea, been an executive officer of a Marine unit at the Marine Corps Base Hawaii, and most recently reported to Navy Region Hawaii as a sexual assault prevention and response officer.
Wow, that's amazing. Can you talk more about how far the Navy has come in this area?
Wow, there have been so many changes. When I first joined the Navy, you didn't see commanding officers, you didn't see command master chiefs serving in positions of responsibility or as women. What you now see is women in significant roles of power. Just take Admiral Michelle Howard, who's leading forces in Europe and Africa. Just look at Vice Admiral Nora Tyson, who is leading Third Fleet during RIMPAC 2016.
Even here in our own backyard, we've got Fleet Master Chief Susan Whitman, who's a senior enlisted sailor for the Pacific Fleet. There's so many examples, and opportunities abound for women to serve in the Navy. And now they are actually increasing more and more child development programs. And so you're finding that you're not having to choose between having a career and having a family.
I love these pictures that you brought. I mean, just it's just so powerful to see this, the women in uniform. It's so great. And what would you say to anyone, any woman who's looking to join the Navy?
I would say absolutely, what a great choice. What opportunities abound. It's an opportunity to put service before self, to serve in defense of our great nation. And on a practical and personal side, there's some really tangible benefits. There's education benefits. You get to travel, and you get equal pay for equal work.
That's right. And how has your time here been?
Oh, I have truly enjoyed my time in Hawaii. I've actually been stationed here twice. My husband, daughter, Bella, and I, we live in Kailua. We love it. And I honestly believe that here in the islands, that the work that the Navy does is appreciated. Mm-hmm. And we really appreciate that support.
You just said you had a daughter named Bella. Is she looking to join the Navy?
Well, I'm not sure about that, but I think she's getting the message. And if I can share something that she wrote last year,
sure,
that'd be great. So this is how I think we know that the message is translating. It's not my opinion that matters. It's the opinion of our children. And she said, "I am a girl. I can. I can make a difference. I can stand up for what I believe in. I can fight for what I believe in. I won't let anybody tell me what's wrong and what's right. I'll do things my way. I'll stick to what I believe in to the end."
That melts my heart. It does. She's only 9 years old and she wrote that?
Well, she wrote it when she was 10.
Okay.
So.
All right. Well, sounds great. Well, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you very much.
Right,
and I appreciate your time today.
All
right, aloha.
Thank you.
Thank you.